Hi, I'm Barry Evans. I'm Business Manager for Skills Tech Alex Hill Training Centre. Today is all about combining TAFE Queensland, Brisbane and Skills Tech with a girls' try the trade. What started out as doing the wet trades has grown in a week, 4 days into a very big day. And we've included students from past apprenticeships as in motor mechanics, plumbing and electrical. And also we have all displays from hairdressing, horticulture, engineering, auto, dentistry, animal husbandry, paving, and landscape.
Hello, my name is Helen Young. I'm a workplace training officer with South Bank Institute of Technology, and we offer courses for dental assisting, dental technology, and dental prosthetists. Today I'm here at the trade display, and we're offering school-based apprenticeships, which means that there's no fees attached, and they can get a Certificate 3 qualification in dental assisting.
I'm Cassie. I'm a past student of TAFE Brisbane. I'm now a teacher in bakery and also look after the bakery apprentices at TAFE Brisbane at South Bank.
Hi, I'm Deb Smith and I'm actually a hospitality teacher at South Bank TAFE. I am currently teaching diploma in hospitality, have done for 15 years. Absolutely loving my job and love working in it at South Bank where the facilities are fantastic. Thanks.
My name's Liam Peters. And I attend Australian Institute of Trade College, and I really enjoy the college.
My name is Jacob Tukey, and I'm from the Australian Industry Trade College, and I enjoy the college as it will help me with a future, better future, and yeah.
Hi, my name is Sean Keenan. I attend the Australian Industry Trades College, and I really enjoy this college from my previous college as it gives me a better opportunity for my future.
My name is Ryan McKellen from the Australian Institute of Trade College, and I like the school's values and the opportunities that it gives you for a better future.
Yeah. My name is Sam Patterson. I go to the Australian Institute of Trade College, and I like that it gives you their trade skills and work for apprenticeship.
I'm Stuart Weir, and I attend the Australian Institute of Trade College, and I like it because I get to do what I want to do. So it's fun.
Because it's given us a good opportunity to do what we want to do, and it's given us values and what we need to get into the trades that we want to get into, and it's giving us opportunities to test what we want.
TAFE Queensland Brisbane, which is Steve Houghton here, Steph and Alan from AITC, and of course us from Skills Tech.
As Barry mentioned, I'm the Business Development Manager for TAFE Brisbane. So we're the guys in green, so we've got the coffee machine, we've got floristry, we've got the paving, we've got dentistry, animal studies, we've got the cooking, and we've got childcare, and we've got the hairdressing. So
thanks, Steve, and thanks, Barry. As Barry introduced me, my name's Al. My pleasure to open up a brand new school here in Redlands in January 27, actually. We start down at Toondah Harbour. That's next year. Why did it come about? It came about because of our local government. Around about two and a half years ago, our college on the Gold Coast started to say, right, we're going to talk to Redlands about what their needs are. In actual fact, the Mayor Karen Williams was right on board from day one. And I guess that's the main reason why we're in Redlands. There are young people in Redlands, and I'm looking at a heap of you girls now, that will one day, hopefully, complete your training in Redlands and then be employed in Redlands. It's girls only today. Why? Because girls, you belong in a number of areas.
I'm excited. I'm really excited. excited to see all you here today. It's great that we've got girls only. When it's girls only, we can say, you know, girls can do anything and girls rock. But a lot of the time, people tell us we can't do anything. We can only do certain things. So you're here to find out today about some of the options and things that you probably hadn't even thought about. And maybe if you'd mentioned it, someone might have said to you, oh no, girls don't do that. Well, girls can do anything. And one of the things about girls doing this just without the boys around is that if open, you'll actually get in amongst it without worrying about what they think of you. We've got some great speakers for you here today. We've got Helen here, who runs a business called Plumettes. She's an all-female plumbing business. Okay. Then we've got Ashley here. Ashley works for Greyhound Australia. She went to go to university. Doesn't go to university anymore. She's got a story about that. Then we've got Janita and Laura. Laura and Janita. Sorry, Juanita. Got here finally. From Eve's Renovations, and they're female carpenters. And then we've got Brad Miller here from Busy at Work, and Brad was also our carpenter once upon a time. Now she works for an apprenticeship centre. Plus we've got Caitlin over the back, who's an apprentice mechanic. Now those are all fairly male-dominated trades.
I was in high school like you guys, stuck in a classroom day in, day out, looking out the window. Couldn't wait to get outside, be outside. I actually ran away from home at the ripe age of 18 and became a chippy. But I started the trade, and about 3 months into it, I wanted to quit. It was hard. The nail bag was heavy. Every day was difficult. But I got through my first 3 months, and then I began to love it.
Quick question for you. Who here has been told that they can't do something because they're ladies? We're in an age now where we should be accepted equally as the men are. When I first started my apprenticeship, I got told that I couldn't be a plumber because I was a girl. At the end of the day, I wanted to plumb. I wanted to do something different, and so I did.
I have a different story to these ladies here. I actually, I went to university for a couple of years and I hated it, basically. And I got halfway through it and I'm like, what am I doing? Why am I doing this? I'm doing this because my parents told me that I should do it. I found a traineeship with Greyhound Australia. It's a bus company. They own over 250 buses all across Australia. So we have bus drivers, freighties, mechanics, all different kinds of positions available. So I started working in the head office, doing a business and admin traineeship. It's still an industry that's very much male dominated. And I was looking after workshops and mechanics who don't want to listen to anything that a girl has to say, specifically a young girl as well.
I'm in a renovation company 5 years ago. We employ women and men. It's whoever's best for the job. We don't employ women just because they're women.
Did anyone watch the Melbourne Cup?
Yeah.
Who was the jockey?
Michelle.
Michelle. Did anyone know about Michelle before Tuesday? Pretty amazing woman. She went about her job. She did the time. She did an apprenticeship. She nearly, you know, got killed on the back of a horse, you know, twice. It just shows that if you want to do something and you want to head in one direction, that you can do it.
If you have a dream, follow it. I started in the industry about 15 years ago, and one of the things that I found a trade was great for, I'm from Ireland, so I got my first trade over there. And it's a passport. Having a trade is a passport to travel to any country, anywhere in the world.
This gentleman is Dave Gardner, an engineering teacher, and this gentleman here is Peter Hall, the auto teacher. And this young lady is the shining light for a lot of you. She came here in year 11, and she went into auto with Peter against 14 guys. Very short time, she started to shine above those guys. In year 12, she went to engineering, again against 14 other guys. Came to me and said, I want to be an apprentice motor mechanic. And I said to Troy, I've got a young girl at college. She wants to be a mechanic. And they said, let's give her a go. The rest is now history for Caitlin. She's second year apprentice. Girls, the reality is we've got mechanics, we've got carpenters, we've got plumbers, we've got electricians. And we as teachers here work on the basis of equality.